Good Saturday morning, everybody. Live and direct from downtown Memphis, Tennessee. I'm meteorologist Austin Onick. It's a beautiful and cool start to the day. No major problems being seen across much of the Mid-South right now, but we do have, again, the possibility of a few areas of showers and thunderstorms as we get into the course of the rest of the weekend. It's not huge, but it is still going to be possible, and we'll talk more about that coming up here in just a little bit. So if you have any plans for outdoors, go ahead and keep them. But as of right now, again, we have little, if anything, really to worry about. So great news for outdoor activities. We've got, again, the possibility of some areas of some very warm conditions across much of the Mid-South as we go into the next several days. Not much is going to be changing for the next several days on the seven-day forecast, which we'll take a look at coming up here in just a little bit. Thanks to everybody for joining us for early this morning on Saturday. Again, it's a beautiful start to the day. We'll show you some of our webcams from around the area, and we'll take a look and see what's going on with the rest of your forecast in just a little bit. Let me go ahead and get our Facebook viewers in here so they can see a little bit more about what's going on. And if you're just joining us on Facebook, again, we've got some good conditions in the Mid-South for heading out for a stroll or a jog. We don't have, again, too much of anything to worry about in the way of moisture anytime soon. So, again, much of what we're looking at this time is going to be pretty quiet for the time being. Currently looking out and around Germantown at the City Hall camera. Again, little, if anything, showing up in the way of rainfall out across the Mid-South. We do, again, have some areas of scattered showers taking place well off to our west. We'll show you that coming up here in just a little while. If you'd like to see more about our WeatherBug cameras, go to wreg.com/webcams, and I'd be glad to have you along for the ride on that, as well as seeing what's going on around the Mid-South. Radar out there, again, little, if anything, showing up at this point. We do have a couple of showers very close to around the area of Little Rock, very light amounts of moisture showing up with some of those clouds out there, but beyond that, we just don't really have much of anything taking place at this point, and that is going to be the way it works throughout the course of the rest of the weekend. So good news on that for right now. Currently in the Mid-South area, we have little, if anything, going on. The temperatures are actually pretty mild out there. We've got numbers back into the lower to mid-60s at some of the recording stations in and around the Mid-South area. We did possibly see the potential of maybe some visibility problems out there, but we do not have anything going on in the way of visibility issues out there. Visibility of 10 miles or less across much of the area. So good news on that for this morning. And temperatures around the Mid-South also looking very nice. We've got mainly mid to upper 50s to lower 60s on our live real-time WeatherNet sites out there. 59 degrees at Ole Miss at the University of Mississippi, 59 at Dyersburg at the airport, and 59.7 just below 60 degrees at the Kaywood School in Lexington. And you can access all that information by going to wreg.com/webbugs at our weathercams out there, and all kinds of other stuff to take a look at as well, including our webcams out there. The webcams available at wreg.com/webcam. So tons of weather information available from across the Mid-South area at this time. So looking very quiet there. Likewise, when it comes to earthquakes, we do not have much of anything going on at this point. Little, if anything, showing up in the way of earthquakes across the Mid-South. That's important that we don't have anything going on, and the fact that we have this map available to us, that we'll talk more about why that is coming up here in just a little bit. Down to the south and west of us, we do have, again, a few scattered light showers around the Arklatex into the Rio Grande Valley and into around northern Mexico. Beyond that, we're just pretty light on moisture. We do have an area of disturbance across Florida in the far right-hand side of the state back over toward Orlando. We do have, again, a little bit of activity going on with a new tropical disturbance making its way into that portion of the state. It's nothing immediate just yet that we're going to be having to cause any issuance of any watches or warnings or anything like that, but it is still something to watch out for. And again, you can see that right over Florida at this time, circulation moving in from the west, and going to continue to see rain, showers, and thunderstorms. 20% coverage chance of this thing developing into something larger, and not good news for Puerto Rico as we see a new storm system developing here. But fortunately, the latest forecasts give this thing a 0% chance of developing into anything. That's the way it looks right now. That could easily change as we go into the course of the next couple of days. So definitely want to stay tuned for more information about what we may be seeing out of that storm system coming on through. Again, this is something that could develop. Remember that we are still right in the middle of hurricane season at this time, and we need to be prepared for stuff like that, especially if you are traveling to anywhere in the Gulf, Florida, or anywhere off the East Coast. This is going to be imperative for you to pay attention to. Lee and Maria. Lee is now a tropical depression, not much left of that, and Maria is also now a tropical storm. If this continues in the next several days, it may be heading for Ireland and the British Isles as a new storm system. So this could be something that could be kind of interesting to see how this affects the weather into and around the British Isles coming up pretty soon, but not a threat to us, and we'll keep our eyes on those other storm systems going on into the Caribbean and the area around Florida coming up a little bit later on. Otherwise, we have little, if anything, going on, again, directly in the Mid-South. Things are very quiet at this time. Nothing expected in the way of problems over the next several days. We do, again, have high pressure in control, keeping things very dry and, again, exceptionally quiet. Anything in the way of storm systems is kind of being blocked by this thing back to the north and west of us. Now, by Sunday, parts of the viewing area around portions of, say, northwest Mississippi, southeast Arkansas, that's where we may see the possibility of some of these thunderstorms wandering northward, but we're not looking at anything in the way of huge amounts of precipitation coming on through. It's just going to be random wandering showers and thunderstorms, and that's really going to be just about it for most of the area, so just not that much going on when it comes to coverage out there. Welcome to everybody on Facebook who's checking in. Phyllis Ridley, Sherry McCray, thanks for dropping by. Angie Rose, Eloise Schaffner, a shower would be helpful. Yes, no question about that, to settle the dust. Leanne Traubach, hope I'm saying that right, thanks for joining us. And Edith Billings, man, thanks for stopping on by. Rest of the weekend, here we go with the temperatures. Very nice today, mid to upper 70s to lower 80s. Cloud cover into tonight will be diminishing to nearly clear skies, good for stargazing. Low temperatures tonight in the lower 50s, maybe even a few upper 40s across northwest Tennessee and northeast Mississippi up around the Boot Heel. Heading into Sunday, high temperatures back into the lower to mid 80s, so very cool. Quiet conditions seen there, and no problems at all basically throughout the rest of the entire weekend. Now, for the 7-day forecast, we are going to throw in a very slight chance of some showers and thunderstorms. Sunday and Monday, there is going to be that potential of seeing some activity again, mainly across northeast Mississippi. We're just not northwest Mississippi, pardon me, into and around the area, coming close to around portions of southeastern Arkansas. It's very minimal at this time, and actually the best time frame for anything involving heavier weather would be coming up on Monday evening, but we're also just not seeing too much of anything else in that respect at this time. So less of anything out there except for stable, warm weather, and that's the way it's going to continue throughout the course of the next several days. I did mention that it is, again, the area into the country for this time of the year, making its way through this time of the month. It's time to be prepared for what goes on when it comes to disasters, and this is something that you can get ready for. This is something that is really handy to have around to get ready for it. It's from the Federal Emergency Management Agency, ready.gov. If you would like to get your family ready for disasters, talking about it is important, making certain you know what to do beforehand. Winging it is not a plan. So best opportunity for you to get ready is to do so now. It's a good opportunity to talk about what to do if mom and dad aren't home. Can you go to your neighbors? Do you have a contact point out of town? If you have to evacuate, do you have a go bag? Do you know how your kids know how to turn the gas off outside in case it becomes necessary? Firefighting, anything like that. Getting ready to get into a disaster, say severe weather, the earthquake from the New Madrid Fault, God forbid, anything in the way of terrorist actions. If you need to talk about it, now is the time, and this is one of the best places you can do so, at ready.gov. We'll be posting more about that, also more about Banned Books Week coming up, and this is going to be finishing up today, so find out more about censorship there. Also available on my Twitter page, and also available on my Periscope page as well, so stop by for more information, and I'll be glad to have you along for that in the course of the near future. Don't forget that you can also pick up my forecast on AM 730, Yahoo Sports Radio, Monday through Friday with Bob and Josh, and on the weekend, Saturday and Sunday, Country 92.5 and Oldies 102.3. I got to go ahead and head back out onto the set, join Melissa Moon with the rest of the last hour of News Channel 3 Daybreak, so stay tuned for more there. Questions, concerns, ideas, comments about what we can feature on here, austin.onick@wreg.com. Love to have you along for the the ride. Please let me know what it is you'd like to see on here, and I'd be glad to feature them if at all possible. Thanks for joining us for Saturday morning's edition of News Channel 3's exclusive video weather blog, Weather Overtime, and stay tuned to WRAG.com/weather and through News Channel 3 on air and online throughout the rest of the weekend, and we'll keep you informed.